Shalom, today's Daf Yomi is Berachos Daf Chof Aleph, Berachos 21. And today's Daf Yomi, our Gemara is discussing the obligation to make a blessing after eating food, that's called Berachos HaMazon, and the obligation to make a blessing before studying Torah, and that is called the Berachos HaTorah. So says our Gemara, Amar Rav Yehuda, Minayin, Berachos HaMazon, La'acharea, Mena Torah. How do we know, what's our source, that the obligation to recite a blessing on food after we eat is from the Torah? And he says it comes from Deuteronomy chapter 8 verse 10, where it says v'achalta v'savata uverachta, you'll eat, you'll be satisfied, then you must bless. And says the Gemara, minayin l'berachos haTorah l'fanam min haTorah, how do we know the obligation to recite a blessing before the Torah, before we study Torah? Some say that this is before we make the blessing on the Torah when we're called up for an aliyah, but that is not the normal interpretation. The normative interpretation is how do we know that the obligation to make a blessing before studying Torah is from the Torah, that there's a biblical commandment. And this is based upon the fact that it states before Moshe Rabbeinu started to sing the song of Hazinu, before he said this song, it states, Kishem Hashem Ekra Havu Godol Elokeinu. It says in Deuteronomy 32, verse 3, because for the name of God I will call out, give greatness to his name, and that means to respond to main. And then it says, Atzur Tamim Polo. And this is a reference to the Torah that Moshe was saying, meaning to say, he says, I'm going to make a blessing first, then you say Amen. And then after that, he starts to say the song. Says Rabbi Yochanan, Omanu Berachos HaTorah La'acharea Min Berachos HaMazon Mikal V'chomer. He says, we need to make a blessing after the study of Torah. And most interpret this to mean that if somebody were to stop studying Torah to go to sleep, that Rabbi Yochanan is saying such a person would have to make a blessing. And we learned that out from a logical argument from Berachos HaMazon. How so? And also he says, V'Berachos HaMazon L'fanam and Berachos HaTorah Mikal V'chomer, that we have to make a blessing before Berachos HaMazon, before there's the blessing of a motzi, that this should be a biblical obligation, also from a kal v'chomer, from the obligation of making a blessing on the Torah. So what's the argument? Berachos HaTorah L'acharea, how do we know that we're supposed to make a blessing after studying Torah? We learned that out from a kal v'chomer from Berachos HaMazon. And what's the logical argument? Ma mazon she'ein tong lefanav, tong l'acharav, just like Berachos HaMazon, which does not require a blessing before it, biblically speaking. Nevertheless, it requires a blessing afterwards, because it says in the Torah, v'achalta v'savata v'erachta. Therefore, Torah study, she'teuna lefanav, that requires a blessing beforehand, because we said from Kishem Hashem Ekra, eino din she'teuna l'acharav, for sure it should require a blessing afterwards. And also, we learn out the obligation of Berachos HaMazon lefanav, that we have to make a blessing on a motzi before we eat food. We learn that out also from a kal v'chomer from Berachos HaTorah, because ma Torah she'ein teuna l'acharav, just like Torah study, which does not require a blessing afterwards, biblically speaking, because the verse only says Kishem Hashem Ekra Havu Godol Elokeinu, but nevertheless teuna l'fanav, it does require a blessing beforehand. So therefore mazon, so the obligation to eat food, shehu teun l'acharav, which does require a blessing afterwards, eino din she'ein teuna l'fanav, for sure it should require a blessing beforehand. So the Gemara says, but we could challenge that. Iko mifrach, that kal v'chomer can be broken. And it challenges Rabbi Yochanan's statement, because mazon shekein nena, but Berachos HaMazon is different, because the body benefits from eating food. And so therefore, that's the reason why we make a blessing afterwards. But that's not like Torah study, because the body does not benefit from Torah study. And so too, we could break the kal v'chomer from Torah study to Berachos HaMazon about making a blessing beforehand, because we could say, Mala Torah shekein Chaye Oam, because Torah is eternal. And so that's the reason we make a blessing beforehand. But that's not the case with the Berachos HaMazon, because the Berachos HaMazon is only a blessing for food on the stuff that we eat in this world itself. And the Gemara says a further proof that somebody who eats food is not biblically obligated to recite a blessing before it, because we say Ditanan, our Muslim Mivarach Acharav and Mivarach Afanav. For food, we only make a blessing afterwards and not beforehand, biblically speaking, and so therefore it's a refutation on Rabbi Yochanan, who requires a blessing before food, biblically speaking, and after Torah study, also biblically speaking. But we see from here, from our Gemara, that says that one does not receive physical sustenance from studying Torah, and that's why there was an attempt from Rabbi Yochanan to bring this Kal v'chomer. This idea that there is no physical sustenance from studying Torah has both an element of permissiveness, because some say in a situation where, for example, someone asks a non-Jew to turn on a light for them on Shabbos, that one would be allowed to study Torah from that light, even though generally speaking we're not allowed to get direct benefit from something that a non-Jew does for us on Shabbos. In this case, there's no benefit because the person is not physically benefiting. And we say this concept of mitzvah lav ahenes ninu, that we're not getting direct benefit from the blessings. However, even though that's the case, the Avnei Nezer says you're not supposed to study Torah just for the purpose of getting physical benefit. But of course, you're going to get just tremendous joy and benefit from studying Torah. Of course, it's going to be the case. And they say about Rabbi Heschel of Krakow that when he would who used to finish the Shas every year, he would finish it after 9 months because he would do every day 12 dapim, and sometimes he became so physically uplifted just from the study of Torah that he would shout out and say, Ribono Shalom, there's no greater benefit from this. And what am I going to have left in the world to come? I just have your kindness that you're giving me to study Torah. That's how much benefit and joy he had from the study of Torah. So even though the Gemara says there's no benefit, physical benefit from studying Torah, it means that's not the only reason a person should study Torah. But there's no question that the more a person studies Torah, the more a person is going to be joyous and happy and just feeling the warmth of the benefit of studying Torah.